So, honey, would you put on this sexy outfit for me? Mm-hmm. Are you okay with that?
Me?
Yeah.
Bloody hell, that's a question I didn't expect you to ask.
Well,
me.
You opened it up.
In this stimulating, heated debate on the issue of porn masturbation and its effect on relationships, check out whose argument makes more sense.
The bedroom might be a place for the non-holy to express itself, because I believe we're created in God's image and animal's image. And
stop it. Get some help.
And the sex allows the animal, under holy circumstances, which is matrimony for both Jews and Catholics.
It's true that the marriage bed can be defiled, but there is nowhere in the Bible that states that man and women are created in animal's image. That's just a plain lie to justify one's own sinful state of mind.
What if a woman is wearing a regular, what if a man is turned on, which every man is, by an attractive woman in a nice dress? That's a turn on. So, no, please answer.
I will.
So, is that bad?
With his wife. I'm going to answer, but let me unfold this a little bit. I think pornography can sometimes be a difficult thing to define. I would say, and let me see if I can redefine it for you, material that depicts something that's intended to sexually arouse or replace a prostitute. I mean, the word pornography comes from two Greek words, pornographpein, which means the writing or the drawing of the prostitutes. It's meant to serve an erotic function.
And what if the eroticism is then
so I'm okay
expressed with the wife.
I'm okay looking at breasts, and I'm okay looking at bums. And if you go to the Sistine Chapel, you'll see that Catholics are perfectly comfortable with nudity. But I think that nudity can be presented in a way that upholds and expresses the dignity of the person. So I could say, okay, I could look at that and marvel at God's creation and the beauty of woman and the beauty of man.
In Porn Myth, Matt Fratt writes, porn is the business of presenting women's bodies to men for masturbation. To stand against this is not to stand against sex generally, but to stand against a habit of solo sex that turns men into consumers, not lovers. Broadly speaking, sex is meant for procreation and intimacy, and porn destroys the purpose for why sex was created in the first place.
See, what I respect about you and what I respect about Jordan Peterson is that very often you tell us to take the hard road. You're like, yes, it's bloody hard, but be a man. Like, rise up. Choose the harder path. Choose the more virtuous path. I just wish that you or Peterson would be more emphatic when it comes to sexual sins, that of course you're tempted to it. Of course you want to do it. What's interesting isn't why people masturbate to pornography. That's obvious. What's interesting is why people decide they don't want to.
Don't throw in the word pornography. Masturbate alone is a sin to you and evil.
That's correct.
What if he's masturbating to an image he makes up in his brain?
If he's masturbating to nothing, I would consider it an evil.
Okay, fair. Okay.
Yeah.
The problem here is not masturbation per se, but the lustful desire that accompanies it. C.S. Lewis compares masturbation to a dark prison where a person finds illusory escape and grows to love the fantasy world rather than the real one. Freud goes so far to write that masturbation is a primary addiction while all other addictions are only replacement for it.
Once you say masturbation under all circumstances is evil, that's I will admit we part company.
Yeah. And that's fine. I mean, we knew we would disagree.
Yes, that's fine.
And
right.
It's even in secular culture, we make fun of masturbation. We don't seem to be proud of masturbation. Even atheists, there's this big move to stop being a cream puff and masturbating into a sock. And instead of that, control your sexual desire. You're not a dog to be neutered. You're someone who has mastery over your lower passions. So I have a desire for food, but if I eat like a pig, then this is going to be bad for my health, and this would be the sin of gluttony. I could have the desire to masturbate.
But the difference is you can eat.
You're equating orgasm with eating. It's not the same thing.
You did.
No, you're saying that I'm equating them to show that they're dissimilar in that if I don't eat, I die. But it sounds like what you're saying is, well, but the man who never has a woman, surely he should masturbate or else what? And I'm saying he's not going to die.
He's not going to die.
Right. And I think the man should have mastery over that passion and use it appropriately. That's
fair.
What I would say.
Okay.
Yes, a man or a woman will not die because of avoiding masturbation. Sex and porn addictions are realities, writes Matt Fratt, and just as with alcoholism or drug addiction, the label addict does not excuse a person for his actions. Addiction is slavery, to be sure, but it is a chosen slavery. Addicts find freedom not by denying the power that porn has over them, not by denying that their addiction is real, but by admitting it to others and asking for help.